I went back inside. I found my earrings, cut my nails down, looked at some examples of some really good resumes again, and regrouped a little bit. Regrouped my thinking, and I was thinking about what is making me feel all of the things that I described and that I felt in shooting this the first time this morning, which I think I will do like a two-parter video. Just in case I don't, in essence, I don't want to do what I have agreed to pertaining to what may be the next step in my working life. And it's okay to have that decision. It's okay to say no to things. That's the lesson. If it doesn't feel right, you can say no. There's no reason to feel like because you said yes initially that you can't change your mind, or you can't have a second thought about it, and a third thought, and a fourth thought. But honestly, if anything is tugging at you that much, it means something that I say a lot, and my own advice is something I forgot to take during this whole process. And that is, don't live out your backup plan, because you'll just be backed up. I hate to make this comparison, but it's pretty appropriate. It happens to all of us every once in a while, but you don't want to make a habit of creating this situation in your life or in your body. Every once in a while, people get constipated. You eat something that your system can't really digest fully or correctly or completely. Generally speaking, this happens when you don't have enough water in your system. And I almost said boom, but it's not boom if this is your issue. And the next thing you know, you're having trouble releasing the toxins that are the result of what you've ingested. Think about that for a moment. I've had about 26, 27 years of buildup within my psyche, within my heart space, within my life. And I'm having difficulty purging all the toxins, purging all the stuff I don't need, my body doesn't use, the waste product, if you will, from my life. And the waste product from all of this is the worry, the anxiousness, the poor decision making. And what causes all of this, in essence? Say it with me. If you've watched any of my videos from last year, you know the answer. I know the answer. Let's say it all together. Poor self-confidence. And self-confidence consists of self-esteem and self-efficacy. And I knew all this in here. I put it on the back burner for a moment because I've just been going through so much stuff in my personal life this year that it didn't even register. And that's the problem with living out your backup plan. You live out the black up. Oh, that was a faux pas. Sorry. And because I am black, I'm laughing at that. But you live out the backup plan. And the backup plan is sort of like junk food. You know, you can eat some junk food when you're hungry just to have some immediate gratification, or because your body is craving something it doesn't really need, but it's craving it, so you ingest it. It's craving sugar, it's craving salt, it's craving all these things, and you ingest it, and it feels good at the time eating that junk food. It'll do in a pinch, but it doesn't nourish you really. And eating junk food over and over and over again, meal after meal after meal, can create difficulties in excreting the waste product. That's what's happening within my life. Because I've lived out the backup plan, in essence, I made a poor, drastic decision starting at age 18 when I was a high school senior that literally sucked because it sucked the life out of my life. Think about that. Sucking the life out of my life. Because I made one poor decision at 18, I've continued to make a series of poor decisions since then that have led me to feeling how I feel right now. But I made that poor decision at 18 because I didn't have the self-confidence and the self-efficacy and the self-esteem that I needed to make the proper decision. So what was that improper decision that I made at age 18? That decision I made at age 18 was to, it's gonna sound proper, but it wasn't for me, was to go to college, earn a degree in something that was not my passion. I liked it, but it wasn't my passion. I liked it, but it wasn't my calling. I liked it, but it wasn't the thing I dreamt of every night when I went to sleep. And then tried to get a regular job in that field. And notice I said job. I didn't say get work or get to work. And it has screwed me over ever since. So don't do it, people. If you're someone who's watching this and you're like 17, 18 years old, if you're even younger, don't do it. Take it from someone who knows. If you don't do the thing that you're passionate about, you're excited about, it doesn't feel like work to you when you do it, you're going to be backed up for the rest of your life. And you're going to have the hardest time excreting those toxic feelings. Most of the time you end up living hand to mouth, financially, spiritually, emotionally, socially, in every other way. And you end up graying and feeling defeated and depleted. So that's what I'm feeling right now. And because I'm feeling that way, I've got to hit the reset button on myself and this whole career situation. I'm no longer looking for a job. What I'm looking to do is to put myself into the life of my dreams, make those dreams a reality, envision, and that's what's been happening. I mentioned over the past month, I've been waking up and thinking about, oh my gosh, like almost living in my head, in my psyche, what it would be like to have the life of my dreams. Like I wake up because I've dreamt things and doing things in that dream life and feeling like, wow, this feels good. Wow, I'm having the time of my life here. And then I wake up because it's not my real life. I think it's my subconscious telling me, you better get to work, girl, and stop living your backup plan. So you may ask yourself, well, hey, I gotta pay my bills. I gotta try to take care of myself. You know, you may have extra mouths to feed. And that's another thing. I have no excuse for this. I don't have anybody else to take care of but myself. The decisions I make impact other people in my life. But ultimately, I'm a family of one. An immediate family of one. I have a family of origin. But that's it. And I have royally messed up. I've royally screwed up. When I say I've royally screwed up, here's what I mean. Right now, my credit sucks. I'm just being real with you guys. And I worry when any company does a background check on me, what they're gonna find. Second thing is, years ago, someone very close to me committed identity theft against me. And at times, some of that pops right back up, almost like it was yesterday. So then I have to explain and give verification that I am who I say I am. And trust me, if you ever go through that in your life, prosecute the person, because it follows you for the rest of your life. And you need to be free of that. I've forgiven this person. However, sometimes when it comes back up, I'm just like, oh, here we go again. Take a deep breath. Let me pull out my paperwork and my information here. I want to speak very briefly on what I feel self-confidence and self-esteem is. I think that self-confidence comes from, or how you feel about your self-esteem. It comes from comparisons we make in our head. How I am compared to my mom. How I am compared to what my parents have done collectively in their lives. How I am compared to my siblings. How I am compared to other family members in my age range. How I am compared to people I went to school with, graduated from high school with, shared that experience, college, things of that nature. How am I doing with the peers in my age group, in my area, that I know? Are they living abundant, banging, kick-ass lives? If so, and I'm not going to feel very good about myself. And finally, how fulfilled do I feel as a person? Do I wake up every morning going, ah, I'm living the life, thank you, Jesus? Or am I regretting getting up every morning? Am I resetting the snooze? Am I going, and groaning when I get up? Do I feel every ache and pain in my body? Or is the adrenaline in my body just giving me such a rush because I'm so fulfilled and so in my element and in my zone every day that, yeah, I have a few physical ailments, but they don't bog me down really? These are the things that you need to ask yourself. And I'm asking myself these questions right now, and I'm not enjoying the answers. And I think that's why I was feeling the way I was feeling this morning. You know, I'm seizing the opportunity to change what was about to be a disaster. So I'm going to stop creating disasters in my life and creating more buildup, more backup. And I'm excreting that stuff, releasing that stuff right now. Declare it in the name of Jesus. Yes, I know. I used a couple of choice words, but you know, I know him. I just struggle as a person. I struggle as a person every day of my life, but I know him. So I wanted to share that because, you know, I came up with these epiphanies and these gentle reminders And as I say often, don't be a sofa softy. Get off the couch, stop watching TV and numbing your brain out, and get to work. Fulfilling oneself, having work that's a part of oneself, is a lot of work. I've done a little bit of work. Probably done more work than most people, but I need to do some more work. So after I filmed the first time, I did some research and I came up with some ideas on titles to research and titles that may make more sense and an area of expertise that feels good to me, in which I can immerse myself so that I can have a banging kick-ass life. So that's where I am with that. And I'm gonna get going. Another thing I wanna add, now that I've had these epiphanies, these moments of clarity, I've gotta be fast acting. I cannot be slow in Him Hall. I have to do what I have to do and be fast acting with it. Almost like taking a stimulant when you're constipated that will move the waste right on through your digestive tract and get it out. And get it out with enough swiftness, with enough force, if you will, that you don't have to exert yourself physically. It just naturally comes out the way it's supposed to. So, feeling better. Other things. When you realize it's time to move on, move on. Don't look back. Don't look back and see what you're leaving behind you. You know, that's kind of the same thing of breaking up with someone because you know you need to, and then reaching back and trying to grab onto them because you miss who you thought they were. It's the same thing with jobs. Don't look back, move forward. Somehow this always happens. I come in here for one thing and I'm looking at everything else. Valentine's night. Up in Michael's. Lord Jesus. My basket's so far in too bad.